Guys, you are welcome to my channel today. So today we'll be getting ready with me, like Grwm. That's what Grwm stands for. And now I'm not going anywhere. I'm just at home. I want to take pictures. I sew this dress for a long time and I just want to be at home and feel good about myself. So I'll be taking pictures, but in this video I want to style my hair for the picture, probably an afro look. Or if the afro does not work, I'll put it in an eye bun. But as all this is going on, I'll be talking about a very, very important topic. A topic that concerns me a lot. Stay tuned. I hope I don't bore you guys. I really hope I don't bore you guys. Adios. Welcome back, guys. So, I don't know if you noticed, but I actually had to take off the arm of the dress because I cannot lift up my hand like I can. I could not lift up my hand like I can now to actually just take down my cornrows and style the hair. So yeah, when I got this video idea, I was like, okay, chit chat, who wants to hear what you want to talk about? Who wants to waste their data listening to you and all what you have to say? But turns out it was also an assumption for me, because here you are listening to me and I really, really hope I don't bore you out, and I'm going to try as much as possible to make sure that this video is not a long or lengthy video. It's just say what you want to say, do what you want to do and be done with. So to the topic, assumption. Okay, this topic here, I'm just going to say how I see it, because everybody has a way they see things. But seriously, everybody assumes, and the main reason why we assume most times is to be on a safe side. Like what if this, what if that. I can remember quite well, and I think a friend of mine will remember too. There was a time that a very good friend of mine lost his mom, and that day I just saw it, like Jesus Christ. And my friend was beside me and I was like, so hey, this person's mom has died. Oh, what will I tell this person? I don't know what to say. What if the person doesn't even want to talk? What if this, what if that, what if this? And my friend was like, just calm down, Dara. You've heard already. You cannot say you did not hear. So just try to reach out. Seriously, when it comes to me and when bad things happen to people, I'm just scared. I'm so withdrawn. I'm like, oh God, I can't face this person. I don't know what to say to this person. Until the bad thing happened to me, when I failed my exams, hey, see, you understand. Like, you understand. Like, it's like a particular position to just let you see things and see how things are. Because when this happened, there was a time, like, I just used to have mixed feelings. Like, someone very close to me be like, Dara, what do you even want? What do you want? What do you want? I'm like, see, I don't even know what I want. There's a time that, during the period, I'm still in the period anyways, there was a time that I did not want to hear, oh my God, I'm so sorry about what happened. Like, I legit put off my phone. I don't want to hear sorry. I don't want to hear anything like that. Everybody should just leave me alone. There was another time that it was like, ha, hey, this person not even call me. This person will say she not here. I mean, really say she not here. But see, let me just tell you, all these things. I now decided to put myself in their shoes, because normally when I first started experiencing when the whole thing first hit me, like thing hit me hard, I not even think about anybody. I was only thinking about myself, like, why would this happen to me? Why would this happen to me? Why would this happen to me? And I was there and people were reaching out, blah blah blah, and okay, thank you very much. Thank you. Well, it was still sad. Sometimes it makes me feel good, makes me feel better, and sometimes it just worsens the whole thing, like, oh my gosh, it is me that people are telling sorry. So see, let me tell you, when you have somebody, oh, don't let me go there yet. So I was saying that I decided to put myself in their shoes. Now, this is it. I decided to think like they would think, like I would think if it was somebody else that this happened to. Because number one, it is either somebody hears and the person is like, hey, Jesus Christ, let me call her. Oh my God. Or, and that person knows, and the person is just so sad that the person will not even know what to say. Like, I don't know what to even tell this girl now. What am I going to say? Like, yeah, something like that can happen. And some other things like that, because I don't know. But the fact that if I decided to stay in my own lane and just assume that they don't like me, that's why they did not call. Or I just assume that the reason why everybody is on their own is, should be, if this did not happen to me, everybody will still be like this. It's just assumption, because assumption is when you are taking a truth, like you decide to say this is true without proof. It's just something that you just want to believe that this is how it is happening, this is how it is, this is the this is what is going on and stuff. This is Jesus Christ, this is more true. So the assumption from my own part, I had to just quickly do away with it. Although we are all humans, so it's possible to happen. But what I'm saying is that you should try as much as possible to just see things from people's perspective sometimes. Then I think it will make things better. Sometimes it is not they don't like you, they don't want, or this has happened and now you know your true friends. Seriously, it's not like that. It's really not like that. Sometimes when you are going through something bad, just have an open mind. Seriously, just have open mind. And for those of us, people like me, that don't know how to reach out to people when they are going through something, it is the assumption that is killing us in a way. So let us just at least take a step, because here, being there for somebody is a big thing. You cannot just, the person will not know that you are there. You are saying you are praying for the person, but you are not reaching out. You are just there. How would the person know that that you care? So my mouth is already paining me. And I said I want to do chit chat. Hey, Jesus Christ. Okay, let's continue. Yeah, so assumption is a big thing. Assumption can kill your relationship. See, let me tell you, this one, don't look at me like somebody that does not assume, because I'm not trying to preach. I'm just really talking out of things that I've assumed that actually turned out to be wrong. Like, I just assumed that maybe this person is avoiding me, or maybe this person doesn't like me like she used to, or things like that. Everybody is going through something. So the fact that you are going through something bad does not mean that, and the fact that you are going through something bad and somebody is trying to be there for you, they are trying to cover, like they're trying to make you feel better, doesn't mean that you take it as their duty. Because everybody has what it is that they are also going through. And as I'm talking, you will know deep down that there are some things that you have assumed about a person, about somebody, that is really, 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 really wrong. And funniest thing is that you assume that, you know, but you did not assume it alone. When you assumed it, you took it as a truth and you still kept spreading it. You assume that this person is like this and you tell somebody. By the time you now figure out that, hey, Jesus Christ, this person is really, really, really not like this, so then you just keep quiet because you don't want to be wrong. That is really bad. It's really bad. It's not something you should do. I remember there was this time, there's this girl that I did not like. Like, I just used to feel like, what is wrong with this girl? Like, I'm trying to greet you and you just carry your eye. Or I'm trying to do this and you just do this. And I just concluded, oh, well, this girl, she's rude. Oh, rude, Pani. And at the end of the day, when we started getting close, I discovered that there was actually something that was going on at that time, that I was just like the person that was coming to collect the whole thing that the person had to go through. So it was actually like that. And so that was the period that person was in. And at the end of the day, we turned out to at least smile at each other before we later departed. So it was quite good. And I felt bad because I used to get angry, like, I would get inside the room, I would tell my roommates, oh my god, this girl again. But it turns out that everybody has their own wahala, everybody has their own trouble, as I am too. I have things that people don't like about me. I have things that people don't like. I have things that people will never, never like about me, and that is how it is. So guys, I'm done with the afro look, but after a while I'm gonna take it up. I think it's time I rounded up this video. Thank you for staying and listening and getting ready with me. Thank you for listening. I really appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you. I really appreciate it. On a serious note, thank you. So please don't forget to like. We are getting bigger in this family and we must grow. So please don't forget to like, don't forget to share, and please don't forget to subscribe. See you guys next time. Bye.